Welcome to this session on Gaini's 9 Events of Instruction. By the end of this session, you will be able to list Gaini's 9 Events of Instruction, and describe each of the Gaini's 9 events with examples. When we start creating a course, some common questions that come to our mind are:
I have the source content. What should I do now?
Will my course meet the desired objectives?
How can I ensure that the learners will actually learn something after taking my course?
How can I make the learning process easy for the learners?
How can I enhance the learners' learning experience?
How can I create an effective course?
Let's see how Gaini's 9 events of instruction can help in providing answers to your questions. So, what's the need to study Gaini's 9 events of instruction? Applying Gaini's 9-step model to any training program is a way to ensure an effective learning program. It provides step-by-step checkpoints that assist you to ensure that you present a complete and successful learning experience. Each step is designed to help your learners comprehend the learning content effectively. Gaini's 9 events were given by Robert Mills Gaini, who was an American educational psychologist. He pioneered the science of instruction during World War II, when he worked with the Army Air Corps training pilots. He went on to develop a series of studies and works that simplified and explained what he and others believed to be good instruction. He was also involved in applying concepts of instructional theory to the design of computer-based training and multimedia-based learning. Gaini's book, The Conditions of Learning, first published in 1965, identified the mental conditions for learning. It is in this book that Gaini gave the 9 events of instructions. These provide a step-by-step approach that can structure our training so that the learners get the most from their learning opportunities. Each step highlights a form of communication that aids the learning process. When each step is completed in turn, learners are much more likely to be engaged and to retain the information or skills that they're being taught. If you use this approach before any type of training session or presentation, you'll remember how to structure your session so that your people get the best possible learning experience. We have listed Gaini's 9 events on the screen. These are: 1. Gain attention. 2. Inform learners of objectives. 3. Stimulate recall of prior learning. 4. Present the content. 5. Provide learning guidance. 6. Provide practice exercises. 7. Provide feedback. 8. Assess performance, and 9. Enhance retention and transfer to the job. While some believe the 9 steps are ironclad rules, it has been noted for quite some time that the 9 steps are more like guidelines or a checklist. These are general considerations to be taken into account when designing instruction. Although some steps might need to be rearranged, or might be unnecessary, for certain types of lessons, the general set of considerations provide a good checklist of key design steps. Let's discuss these events in details. Gain attention. Start the learning experience by gaining the attention of your audience. This change in stimulus alerts the learners that learning will soon take place. You can do this by presenting a story, problem, question, or a new situation that will grab the learner's attention. This can be thought of as an interest device or teaser, such as the short segment often shown in a TV program right before the opening credits that keeps you watching the program. The ideal is to grab the learner's attention so that they will become involved in the learning process. Provide a learning objective. Next, you must ensure that your learners know what they need to learn, and that they understand why they're about to learn this new information. This allows the learners to organize their thoughts on what they will learn and to perform. There is an old saying: first tell them what you're going to tell them. Then tell them, and finally tell them what you told them. Therefore, you need to tell the learners the objectives and the purpose of the training. Stimulate recall of prior knowledge. When your people learn something new, match the new information with related information or topics they've learned in the past. This allows the learners to use two important learning processes. Retrieval practice. Retrieval enhances learning by retrieval-specific mechanisms rather than by elaborative study processes and is an effective tool to promote conceptual learning. Scaffolding is building upon the learner's previous knowledge and skills. Associating new information with prior knowledge can facilitate the learning process. It is easier for learners to encode and store information in long-term memory when there are links to personal experience and knowledge. A simple way to stimulate recall is to ask questions about previous experiences, an understanding of previous concepts, or a body of content. Present the content. Present the new information to the group in an effective manner. Content should be chunked and organized meaningfully, and typically is explained and then demonstrated. To appeal to different learning modalities, a variety of media should be used if possible, including text, graphics, audio narration, and video. Provide learning guidance. To help your learners learn and retain the information, provide alternative approaches that illustrate the information that you're trying to convey. To help learners encode information for long-term storage, additional guidance should be provided along with the presentation of new content. Guidance strategies include the use of examples, non-examples, case studies, graphical representations, mnemonics, and analogies. Provide practice exercises. At this stage, you need to ensure that your people can demonstrate their knowledge of what you've taught them. The way that they show this depends on what they're learning. Therefore, the learner is required to practice the new skill or behavior. Eliciting performance provides an opportunity for learners to confirm their correct understanding, and the repetition further increases the likelihood of retention. You can provide learners with simulations, games, quizzes, and practice exercises. Provide feedback. After your learner demonstrates their knowledge, provide feedback and reinforce any points as necessary. As learners practice new behavior, it is important to provide specific and immediate feedback on their performance. Unlike questions in a post-test, exercises within tutorials should be used for comprehension and encoding purposes, not for formal scoring. Additional guidance and answers provided at this stage are called formative feedback. Assess performance. Learners should be able to complete a test, or other measurement tool, to show that they've learned the material or skill effectively. Upon completing instructional modules, learners should be given the opportunity to take, or be required to take, a post-test or final assessment. This assessment should be completed without the ability to receive additional coaching, feedback, or hints. Mastery of material, or certification, is typically granted after achieving a certain score or percent correct. A commonly accepted level of mastery is 80% to 90% correct. Enhance retention and transfer to the job. In this last stage, learners show that they've retained information by transferring their new knowledge or skill to situations that are different from the ones you've trained them on. Creating electronic or online job aids, references, templates, and wizards are ways of aiding performance. In the previous screens, we had a look at Gainey's 9 events. What you see on the screen are the Gainey's 9 events in random order. Now let's see if you can arrange these events in the correct order. The correct order is as per the numbers displayed on the screen. Now that you can list the Gainey's 9 events in the correct order, let's learn more about the Gainey's events through an example. The sales and marketing personnel in an organization are required to use a new customer relationship management or CRM software. You have to teach them the features of this CRM software. How will you use Gainey's 9 events in this scenario? In this scenario, you can gain attention by presenting a scenario in which a sales, marketing employees are discussing their frustration with the current tools and processes. You can conclude with a lead-in, "There's a better solution out there." Another thing that I want to mention here is that there are numerous other ways of gaining attention. Due to limited time for this session, we will be touching only some of the examples of this and other Gainey's events. You can state the objectives for this scenario like: by the end of this session, you will be able to identify the features of the CRM tool, to recall prior learning, you can list scenarios that relate to how the sales and marketing team currently do business, to present the content, provide overview of the new CRM tool, detailed descriptions of major tasks, and provide simulations of critical tasks, to provide learning guidance, give learners real-life examples of when and how learners will utilize the new CRM software, for providing practice, have the learners walk through a guided simulation of inputting data into the new CRM system. During multiple choice exercises, if the learner answers incorrectly, give an explanation, diagnostic feedback, provide hints, tips, or links to content to reiterate concept. In this scenario, a possible assessment can be having learners complete a simulation without guidance, to enhance retention and transfer of learning to the job. We can include mini movies or tutorials in the new system to help guide learners if they forget a particular task. That brings us to the end of the session. Here is a recap of what we learned on the previous slides along with some additional examples. Thanks a lot for being part of this session. We would be coming up with more interesting and informative sessions soon. Till then, keep learning.